Welcome to a session on array of characters or array of alphabets and other symbols on the keyboard known as strings. So in order to understand array of characters, a lot of the concepts are very similar with array of integers or floating point or double numbers. But there are a few really important differences. The first one of them is each of the series of messages or strings is going to have variable length. Like your name may not be the same length as my name. That is why what C does is, when my name ends, it terminates it with a special character called as the null character. We'll head there as and when required. So first, let's try to take a look at the very fundamental concept of arrays, that is character arrays, by giving them initial values. Suppose I have declared a character array called as name, but I have not given it the length. So what I have done here is, I have initialized it with GEU. So what you can assume is, this array is located at address 1000 in the memory. So G will be at 1000, E will be at 1001, U will be at 1002. Then I know that GEU has ended, so there is a special character called as the null character. The ASCII value of this null character is 0. It is not the character 0. This character 0 has an ASCII value 48, whereas this null character has an ASCII value 0. So what happens after this is, since I have given it GEU null, the null indicates that GEU has ended. Now, what is the length or what is the dimension of this particular name array? It is going to be 1, 2, 3 and 4. So you can think this as name of 4. So the size of this particular array is determined automatically based on how many characters I initialize plus one character for the null. If I am initializing an array of characters, one character at a time, it is my responsibility to put the null character. Failure to put the null character will end up printing garbage values after you. When you're taking a look at the demo video which follows this particular video, you will get a better idea of what kind of garbage output you may get. Now, what I have done here is, here I have given it the dimension of 5. So it's going to look something like this. It's going to say G, U, okay, the null character, and after this, all will be nulls. So C is automatically going to put nulls for all of this, and this all the way till 5 characters. So this is 0th character, 1, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. So totally, these are 5 positions. So this is the beginning and ending of your array based on this particular declaration. Now next, what I have done is, I have again declared name, but I have failed to give it any size. But if you observe carefully, this is initialized with the double quote. When I initialize an array using double quotes, C does me a favor. All that I have to do is just give this GEU. It automatically inserts the null character for me. So this is preferred initialization over this, because here I need to put the null character as the end. Otherwise, the behavior becomes undefined and unpredictable. Now this is again very similar. Name of 5, GEU, it is going to look something like this, except that, sorry, it's not going to look something like this, there is a difference here. Char name of 5, GEU, there is a space and this thing. So it is going to be like this, GEU, okay, I'll indicate space by this, and then this null character will be automatically inserted by the C compiler. So here if you see, it is GEU, there is a space after U, then there is a null character. So the addresses you can assume of this name array here can be 1000, 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004. Now what is the width or length of this? It is maximum 5. So I have utilized all the 5 spaces based on this particular declaration. Next one, you will see something interesting. I have declared the width as 5 characters, but I have given totally 5 characters. Now this is problematic. Because why is it problematic? Okay, the reason it is problematic is, I am left with 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So totally these are 5 spaces to store the characters. I have utilized all the 5 spaces to store the character. and I have not given any space to store this null character. Here is a problem. Since you have not given any character to store that any position or any space for that null character, you're going to have a problem when you're trying to use this, because when you try to print it after D, you will see a few garbage characters printed till the printf encounters the first null character. That's when it will stop printing. So this is not a great idea to initialize. At least have one character more than the maximum number of characters you're expecting, because in C, array of characters, or also known as the strings, terminate with a null character. Now, this is interesting. Here what I have done is, here I have created something like this. There is a pointer, it's a variable. Let us say the pointer has an address of 2000. And what I am doing it is, I am giving it the address of GEHU and let's say null here. I have not shown the null because that automatically gets added. Let us say G resides at address 500, E resides at address 501. So since I have given it a constant, or I have given it a string message enclosed in double quotes, this is known as a string literal. This is going to be stored at some position in the memory like this, 500, 501, 502, 503, and this and 504. So when I say PTR and I give it this particular fellow, in the value contained in PTR is going to be 500. That is, it is going to contain the address of G. So PTR contains the address of G, and PTR itself being a variable, you can assume it exists at address 2000. So what happens is, PTR now indicates it's a pointer to a character type of data. That means it contains the address of a character type of data. Makes sense, because PTR contains the address of G and G is a character type of data. That's why PTR is a pointer to a character type of data. Now, one important thing you need to know, if you initialize, okay, GEHU like this using the pointer or using this particular declaration, you cannot modify or any of these characters. You cannot change G to I, E to F or what it is. This GEHU, when you use this kind of a initialization, char star PTR, this GEHU gets stored in an area of a memory which is read-only or non-modifiable. That's why you cannot modify this GEHU. Now, here I have declared PTR of 20 GEHU, not a problem. So the maximum capacity of this array PTR is 20. It doesn't mean the length of what is contained in that is 20. The length of what is contained in that is only 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the length of the characters is 4, but the length of this particular PTR is not 20. Its maximum holding capacity is 20. Now, there's a difference between character and an array of characters. Here, this is a simple character A. I have given it with a single quote G. This is an array of characters A. I have not given it the width, but I have initialized it with double quote. So it is going to be as good as A of 2, because one character G and one place for the null character. Now, I'll tell you a little bit about the null character. The ASCII value of the null character happens to be 0. Okay, don't confuse it with the number 0 whose ASCII value is 48. So in array of characters or strings, in order to ensure proper behavior, we need to see that the null character is appended at the end of the string. Failure to append the null character results in undefined behavior. Most of the time, C does it for us, but if we are manipulating or writing a code and doing things character by character, it is our responsibility to terminate it with a null majority of the times. So I have shown you a demo of this particular initialization, this particular program. I have shown you following this particular video. Please take a look at the demo to just get a feel of how the output is going to look. So this is the address of name is going to be passed to printf. So it's going to print GEU. Here again it's going to print GEU. The name to address is going to be passed to printf. Again GEU is going to be printed on the third line. Here again not a problem, GU is again going to be printed. Here here's a problem, because capacity is 5, maximum 5, you have not left any space for the null character. So after GEHUD, you are going to have garbage being printed till the printf encounters a null character. Now here what happens is, here PTR contains the address of G. This GEHU resides in an area of memory which is read-only or non-modifiable. So PTR contains the address, so the address is sent to printf. In every case, if you see, the address was being sent to printf because the name of the array represents an address. And PTR2 is an address. So it will keep printing GEHU till it encounters the null. And finally, PTR of 20, GEHU. So here again, you will see GEHU being printed on the output screen. So the way strings are being explained is, there's going to be a theoretical or a conceptual discussion. And each of the session, immediately following that, in the playlist, you will see a video demonstrating this particular piece of code. This way, I believe your understanding of strings or array of the characters is completely thorough.